First, hats off to Meg and the whole organizing committee for this conference. It's really encouraging to see this room, the energy and the bodies, frankly, here on a Saturday morning. So I'm happy to know that I'm with my fellow health tech nerds. So I want to talk briefly about Junto Health, but more importantly, less about us, more about the trends that we saw that caused us to create Junto Health. First, who am I? My name is Doug Hayes. I'm the founder and CEO of Junto Health. Prior to this, I was leading the accelerator micro VC fund at Blueprint Health, which is the health tech accelerator and co-working space down in Soho. Had the pleasure of working with 60 some odd health tech founders to help them make their first sale, get their first investor check, find their first advisors. In a prior life, I was more on the investment side, but most recently coming from Blueprint Health. So the central issue that some of the speakers alluded to already in healthcare today, everyone knows this in this room, is that there's a dynamic wedge happening with existing healthcare stakeholders in the ecosystem. We have top-down payment reform coming at the state and federal level, and we've got a massive disruption coming from new entrants and new competitors, largely leveraging technology to compete against existing stakeholders. So this is the reality that a lot of hospital administrators, pharma, payer executives are trying to wrestle with. So one of our first responses as an ecosystem was to really lean into the startup model. So there's a lot of hype, a lot of excitement around startups, and there are a lot more of them. So in the past, starting a company used to be hard. For those in the front, you might be able to see this, but this is actually the J&J factory over in New Jersey. There needed to be a ton of building materials time that went into this company before they were able to produce a product. Now it's fundamentally different, it's easy. There are many accelerators, there are many co-working spaces, I agree that we probably need more in the city. But with software, you can do a lot more for a lot cheaper, and you can iterate and go a lot faster. So the real issue today is filtering the noise of the early stage ecosystem. So 5 years ago when Blueprint was founded, there were all of three health tech focused accelerators that were using that model. Now there are over 60. Back 5 years ago, there were close to 1,000 new software-based startups in healthcare. Now there are over 10,000. So the issue today is not necessarily creating startups that are solving real needs. It's actually filtering the noise and finding the good solutions that are ready to scale. I had a conversation about this yesterday, I think. In today's age, technology really is the easy part. For those of you who can't see, one developer is talking to the next, and he says, bad news, some kid just created an app that creates apps. And I think this is important for us to recognize as people who deal with technology, who work with founders, who help large enterprises find new tech solutions. In healthcare, I don't have to tell this room, but it really is the second or third concern. Understanding what the real need is and getting buy-in from the end users is the real challenge. So the hard part for founders, as I mentioned, is understanding the business models. Even if you have a good product, it's hard to know who pays for it and why. The sales cycle is atrocious. I'll learn. I'm gonna stand back. The sales cycle is really brutal for early stage companies, and data and integrations is a constant obstacle to full scale. For those who are looking for solutions, the clinicians, there's workflow constraints, they need solutions that are actually validated, and there's very poor UX and UI, which leads to low adoption. So how do we bridge this gap? I think that what we do is invert the product development process. Rather than starting with the technology and using accelerators and hackathons and challenges to push technology out into the market, we want to start with the problem and pull tech solutions into those validated needs with kind of walking in step with the clinicians and providers who have those problems. And we need to develop a repeatable and transparent process for large corporates and large health systems to source, vet, and onboard early stage companies. So a little bit about us and what we do at Junto. So Junto Health is a co-development consortium, so a membership-based organization that represents all the major verticals of healthcare: payers, pharma providers, technologists, entrepreneurs, funders, the policy world. And we use a co-development process to find alignment between large enterprise stakeholders and pull them into clusters, co-development clusters, in which we may have a pharma, a payer, a provider working together to find a new adherence technology, or co-developing, leveraging their resources to build a new predictive analytics platform for behavioral health. We really want to solve the hard, meaty problems, and that takes buy-in and engagement from the large corporates and the large providers from day one. We run quarterly summits based on our belief of getting the right people, the right parts, in the same place on a recurring basis. In this kind of hand-wavy world of new technology, I think the old-fashioned concept of personal relationships between people who have solutions and people who have problems is the way that real innovation happens. And when we find alignment around shared challenges or opportunities, we pull our members into small, agile clusters. These are typically 3 to 5 organizations, and they work together to actually share resources, networks, experience, and to lower the costs and risks associated with new technology adoption. They have 5 phases. We produce output both hard and soft. This could be new technology, new IP, could be new companies, could also be workshops and expanded knowledge resources. And why do they work? They lower costs and risks. They help our members, the large enterprises, to learn more at a faster pace. And they help these large organizations stay nimble and agile by running small disciplined experiments of collaboration and innovation before they double down and really invest in 1 or 2 large ideas. This is an example of the input of any cluster. We start with the problem. We fully bake the way that organizations want to collaborate. So timeline to launch, how many people they want to work with, who, and what they're looking to get out of it. So let me cut myself off now. We are looking for talented individuals to get involved with Junto. As a membership-based consortium, there's always a ton of opportunities to work directly with enterprises and large corporates. If anyone has existing startups and they're looking to try to connect with the demand side of the market, we'd love to meet. We also have a number of fellowships for folks who are interested in that intersection of technology and healthcare. And we do a substantial amount of thought leadership, so if anybody is a writer or a blogger in here, we'd love to meet. So I'll be around for the rest of the day. I want to thank you for your time and attention, and again, I want to thank Meg and the organizers here today, and looking forward to the rest of the presentations.